As we all know, ambiguity is the new norm in organisations today. As leaders, we often really want our people to be comfortable with ambiguity, to just deal with it. But the harsh reality is that few, if any, of our people are truly comfortable with ambiguity. In fact, it's often quite the opposite. So what can we do as leaders to help our people and lead them through these ambiguous times? Well, first of all, it's important as leaders that we are comfortable ourselves with ambiguity, or at least that we recognise and are able to manage our own response to ambiguity. If we don't give off a sense that we're confident, hopeful and optimistic about the future, our people will feed off that. A sense of stress, a sense of worry, of confusion, it's contagious and our people will start to feel those things too. So we really need to manage our own response to ambiguity and come across as confident and hopeful. Secondly, we need to give our people clarity about the organisational values and our values as leaders. What's important? What are our underlying beliefs? And thirdly, we need to give our people clarity about our overall direction. What's the strategic direction of the organisation? Where are we heading in the longer term? What's the overall destination that we're trying to reach? And of course, the approach that we take to getting there may well need to change as a result of changing circumstances. But the overriding destination, that overall strategic direction, should remain broadly the same. So as well as giving people clarity about the purpose, the values, and the direction, which is all about the mission and direction of the organisation, we also need to give them clarity about their specific role and what we require of them, even if that just relates to the immediate goals and priorities. And most importantly, how their immediate goals and priorities relate to that bigger picture.